Hello, guess who? David Ginn, with one of my teacher friends, Mrs. Browning, here at the ABC Elementary School, and her fifth grade student, Michaela. And I've been showing them some comic book covers that I laminated from my collection of Classics Illustrated. There's like Gulliver's Travels backed with Robin Hood. I put a different one on the back of each one. Here's, for instance, The Time Machine, and on the back of it, Alice in Wonderland. So I made up a whole bunch of these. There's Time Machine, Gulliver's Travels, Treasure Island, Alice in Wonderland. I made them all up, and they're all mixed up. They're no two alike. So that allows us to play a little game with these. So here's the way we do this. Why don't you just pull one of those out there, Michaela? Just pull one out. All right. We're going to put that one right down here, just like that. You see Treasure Island? And what we're going to do is stack these up like dominoes. You know, in dominoes, you got like a two, you put it next to the two, and then you put the four to the four. So we're going to do this Treasure Island. Take one of those Treasure Islands and put it face down against Treasure Island. Then we need an Alice in Wonderland. I think you've got one right there. Can you put that against that one? And then the Time Machine is next. Let's see. Time Machine. How about that one? Put Time Machine facing that one. Gulliver's Travels, got two choices. Take one of them. Put it right there. And then we got Alice in Wonderland. You got an Alice over there anywhere? Now here's what happens. If that happens, what you do is just turn the pile over like this. You got a Robin Hood anywhere? All right, put Robin Hood right there. Here's Gulliver's Travels. We'll put that one there. And there's Treasure Island and Time Machine, just like that. And we end up with what on the top? Robin Hood. And what on the bottom? Alice in Wonderland. So, boys and girls, remember that on the bottom we have Alice in Wonderland, and on the top, Robin Hood. That's just the way you stacked them up. It could have been some of these other ones, like the Time Machine. Now, you remember that for a minute, and we're going to leave those right here on the table, just like that. But let me show you what I have in this big bag. I have in this big bag the same comic book covers, but I did bigger blow-ups. Let me just pull one of them out here so you can see it. I've got, there's a giant Gulliver's Travels. Let's see. The Time Machine, that's one of my favorite covers. Look at all the beautiful color, and so on like this. Now, they're in here, the same ones, but only one-sided. They're green, I think, on the back. See, like that? And I'm going to have you, Mrs. Browning, stand right here. And when I open this bag, you're going to reach in here and pull one out without looking. You can close your eyes or look the other way. I'm going to trust you to do that. Just reach in, pull out one, and pull it up against your shirt front, and cover it up, just like that. Now, wait a minute. Before we do this, you know, if I only let her take one, somebody's going to say, that was an accident. It was a coincidence. So, tell you what, reach in and take one more. Just take one more. All right, put that against your shirt, too. And I'm going to put this down. Now, boys and girls, we've talked about reading newspapers, books, magazines, comic books, all kinds of stuff. But you know what? Teachers have another kind of reading. They call it mind reading. And I suspect when I asked Miss Browning to come up here a while ago, that the moment I picked her, her invisible antenna came out. And before she even got up on the stage with you and me, she knew what was going to happen. So that when she reached in here without even looking, she pulled out the exact two pictures that we had stacked up and left on the top and the bottom. Robin Hood and Alice in Wonderland. We're going to find out right now. When I count to three, Mrs. Browning, I want you to turn those pictures out and show which two pictures, which comic book covers you have. You ready?
Yep.
Boys and girls, let's count to three. You ready? One, two, three. Turn them around. What do you have? Robin Hood and Alice in Wonderland. How do you like that? Mrs. Browning is a mind reader. Give her a great big round of applause. Wow. And you know what? I'm going to take those and put them back. But you know, let me tell you something. Boys and girls, you need to know this. Your teachers are mind readers. Why do you think they say this? You walk up to the desk and the teacher will just look at you and go, no. Because she knows what you're thinking already. So if Mrs. Browning tells you to do something, you might as well go ahead and do it, Michaela. Otherwise, she's going to read your mind and find out whether you did it or didn't, and find out whether you're in good shape or hot water. You know what I'm saying? Thank you for giving me a good hand, a good helping hand. Thank you, Miss Browning. Let's give them both a great big round of applause. There you go.